This has been a really great bunch of presentations. I do want to give a shout out to my former employer, who I really learned preservation from, John Misek, who was here earlier. He's really one of the people that got me started looking at preservation. And we have just such a wonderful set of buildings and communities here that, you know, we have the bones, and you can see it right here in Troy, where things are coming back. And, you know, things tend to be cyclical. And, you know, certain neighborhoods tend to, you know, downhill sometimes, and then, you know, you have other influences like 787, which have a huge impact. And in 2002, the city of Albany actually had a couple of different master plans that were done. And there had been some funding associated with that. And Jack may have been helpful in getting some of that funding along. In part, one of them was for the Hudson Fulton celebrations that were anticipated. So there was some funding for that. But there were two distinct areas on the Albany waterfront that they were looking at. The central section of the waterfront had been improved with the bridge that came over, the Band-Aid that was talked about earlier, and there was the amphitheater there. And indeed, it is a really lovely little place once you get down to the river. And so the two different master plans here, the north waterfront master plan really looked at the area that was above what is now called Jennings Landing, up to, you know, the area that deals with where the all the crew comes out, and there's the boat landing and everything else. And it went all the way up where you have Central Warehouse, went up Erie Boulevard, pretty much to I-90. And so this was the area that we're looking at. Here's the Central Warehouse, which everybody's favorite building, sits in Albany and will never come down. If we last 1,000 years, that building will be there because it is hugely, you know, the columns in that building are, you know, 4 feet in diameter, 5 feet in diameter. They actually brought trains inside the building. I mean, this thing is never going to go anywhere. So we got to find a good use for it. So this plan basically deals with an area that was relatively, you know, underutilized is one way of saying it. You know, pretty poor condition. And it has a really interesting history. This spot actually was the beginning of where the Erie Canal came off the river. Right where there's a where the boat landing is, and where the road comes around and comes out at Central Warehouse, right there is the first lock that was located. You had the Albany Basin, which is pretty much where 787 is now. And then you had a lock, which is right here. Central Warehouse basically was right over here. You had a basin that was just elevated off the river. And then you had a way lock. So all of the boats that came in, the barges and everything else, it would basically be weighed, and tariff would be associated with that. And they would continue on into the pretty much right up Erie Boulevard, right in front of where Huck Finn's is today. So this is some of the background of what that area was, and it was something that we looked at within the planning nature of that master plan. We looked at all of the various buildings that were associated in that area. You know, many of them are you know, pretty much defunct factory buildings. You remember you know, all those buildings along Erie Boulevard. It really comes right up almost to the you know, Broadway over on the other side. the team looked at not only planning issues for highways, as well, but you know, all of that circulation and how that comes in. Right now, there's that Colony Street off ramp that comes down, and all of that traffic comes right through there. So that was going to be something that would have to be looked at, and also rail traffic, because this is the one spot where you have two major rail lines that cross right here, right next to the central warehouse. You have the lower line, which is actually a freight line that goes up right through Cohoes and up that way. And you have the Amtrak line, which crosses over the top of it from Rensselaer over to Schenectady. You can see that here. And so one of the thoughts for that area was, okay, given that situation, you know, this would be a great place for an intermodal transportation center. It's a spot where you could really connect. You could have a commuter rail system at some time that actually hits the northern communities and helps relieve some of the congestion and need for 787 and things like that. And you know, it's a place that, again, you know, you have that that connection. You could have all of that happening, you know, part of it in such a warehouse or adjacent to it. But more importantly for the North Waterfront is really creating sort of destination opportunities. So, you know, why do people want to come here? So part of it is the connection with the riverfront. That is something that can easily happen here. Thought was perhaps, as we looked at it, and you can see the overpass right there, it's a spot where you can actually bring the river in to the city. Unlike all the other areas where everything is on the other side of 787, in this instance, 787 is 80 feet up in the air. So you can actually bring the river into the city. That offers opportunities for restaurants, hotels, shopping, recreation, other things. This happens to be the view from the top of that central warehouse building. And it has spectacular views up there. I mean, if you could actually get up and utilize that building, you know, you can see potential for, you know, all sorts of things. It could be a hotel, it could be other things. You know, this is just sort of one sort of fanciful idea about what that might be. And you know, again, you could have all sorts of things happening around. You see Baltimore's Inner Harbor. I mean, this could be Albany's Inner Harbor. And this is the plan that ultimately gelled all of those things together. And you know, I wanted to talk about this plan because actually I think it's one that really has a lot of potential today. It's something that is really worth pursuing because it offers the opportunity of, even if we can't get to the point of taking 787 out of here, this is something that's incremental, and it's something that can really, I think, happen. And it's just been sort of left on a shelf for the last 17, 18 years and forgotten about. But you can come right in off the river. You can go in underneath where that where 787 is so much higher than the ground around it. Create sort of an inner harbor. You have the area where the central warehouse and some of those existing buildings can all become really enlivened. You know, that is something then that ties in with what's happening over on Broadway, with the development that's happening there. This was a time when there wasn't a Rotterdam Aquarium. The thought was, you know, you could put an aquarium right here along in the at that Inner Harbor. You could also have some sports venues that you have indoor sports things. And also that then ties back into having a new building for the rowing club, you know, the ability to attach to all the Corning Preserve and the fields that are here, because you can cross underneath and have all these walkways. And then sort of bringing that up Erie Boulevard, and again, at that time, there was not quite the development of the rail facility that's up here, but the thought of, you know, creating additional development up above. But I think the center core of this plan, you know, would really be something that would enliven and provide an immense amount of opportunity for the city. And really then I help spur all of the development, I think, that could happen in the warehouse district, which has tremendous potential. The other plan was actually the South Waterfront redevelopment plan. And the idea behind that was to really build upon the fact that, you know, Albany is one of the oldest cities in the United States, has this great Dutch history. So sort of focusing on some of that, making, you know, more of it than is made today, because there's really nothing. You know, again, creating a tourist destination. It was really bringing people in and helping to revive that. And so the thought was to create a Fort Orange and Mohican Village Living History Museum and provide a docking area for replica ship Half Moon. And then also on the, still continue to allow for things like the Slater and the Dutch Apple and other shopping venues and things like that. So you can sort of imagine this sort of thing with 787 looming right over the other side of it. So you, this particular one, I had a little problem with thinking how would people actually sort of switch their mind quite so drastically. But so the North Waterfront, I think, had great practicality. This one had just a touch of wishful thinking. But you know, this is where the Slater currently docks. This is basically the U-Haul building up here, and this pretty much brings us all the way down to the Port of Albany. So it really develops that whole lower section of Broadway in here, so that, you know, at the northern end of that, again, you have the walkways that are sort of forced out to the edge because of the 787, but there's still that connection. You can walk from, you know, the center section of the waterfront, you know, down here. This would be, you know, again, more of the shopping area and so forth. And then the, you know, the Fort Orange recreation would be down here with, you know, the little Mohican Village and the ships and everything. So I think these are really interesting plans, especially I think the North Waterfront one, but never got off the